I'm more beautiful than I've ever been because I've experienced so many things and I can relate to so many different people.
Lauren Wasser was born to be in front of the cameras, posing alongside her model parents since birth. Her own career was beginning to take off as she entered her 20s.
It's fun. I like to, you know, be a chameleon and transform and become something else.
But in 2012, her life came crashing down when she contracted toxic shock syndrome, a rare but life-threatening complication caused by certain types of bacterial infections and commonly associated with tampon use.
I just remember being in so much pain and my feet were just burning.
Doctors had to amputate her right leg and toes on her left foot to save her life.
I'm sitting on a little chair with half a leg and like my foot, and I'm just like, this is not real. This is not my life. It was embarrassing. I was ashamed of who I was. I was ashamed of what happened. And my whole identity was just taken from me.
And then last year, after complications, Wasser's left leg also had to be amputated. But she's since embraced her new reality.
I'm just lucky to be alive. You know what I mean? That this didn't kill me, because it really could have. And I feel like my purpose now is to be the face and the voice of this, so people know that it's real and it does happen.
And Wasser continues to inspire others who may be facing similar experiences.
We have amputees who are writing us and saying thank you for showing yourself in shorts. And that's what is so awesome. And it's made all the pain and suffering worth it.
And Lauren Wasser is here with us this morning. Good morning.
Good morning, ladies.
So the doctors gave you a 1% survival rate after you went to the hospital. What was the initial symptom that actually made you go to the hospital in the first place?
I just thought I had the flu. The flu season was around, it was October. All of my friends were getting sick, and I'm an athlete. I'm always active, and I literally just thought it was the flu, literally flu-like symptoms.
So when you talk about how you dealt with this, you say 6 years between losing the first leg and the second. Losing the first leg gave you life. You say losing the second leg gave you freedom.
Yeah, they gave me a 50-50 chance that my left side would survive, my foot. And by the grace of God, I believed that I would fight for it, and I had tried everything I could, but I was still in so much pain and immobile, pretty much. I didn't have toes, and my heel was really badly damaged. And I was going to be 30, and I said I want to be a mom, and I'm an athlete naturally, and I just wanted to get back to being active, and that was the best decision I could have made. Mm-hmm. And I did it for myself because I wanted a better life for myself, so...
And you are rocking these gold legs.
Thank
I mean,
you so much.
These are so cool.
Thank you.
What do they mean to you, and what do they mean for others who are amputees as well?
They are my trophies. You know, they are my strength. I am so grateful. Oser is the prosthetic company that actually develops them, and the relationship that we've built, and what they've allowed me to do in my life every single day. I'm running the New York City Marathon.
You are.
Yeah, and so they've made my running blades.
Also gold.
Also gold, mm-hmm. Of course. Yeah. So. It's pretty amazing.
So we talked about the fact that you were a model before. How has it impacted your career? Are you still modeling? Are you still doing what you love?
I am. I'm back modeling. I'm signed with Adidas right now.
Nice.
I'm doing a lot of things with H&M. I'm getting back in an acting game. You know, mm-hmm. just
Good
trying to do as much as I can and inspire as many people.
So tonight is the Heroes Heart and Hope Gala for the Challenged Athletes Foundation. This is my fourth year emceeing it. I'm bringing my brother, who's also an amputee, because I just think it is the most inspiring event. You're being honored at tonight's event. What does the Challenged Athletes Foundation do, and how important is sports in getting back into your life?
Oh, man, it's everything. I mean, if you don't have your legs, you don't have a life, you don't have your mobility, there's nothing you can possibly do. And CAF allows people to get their lives back. They mm-hmm. provide the prosthetics that are so expensive to people that, you know, can't afford it or just it's not possible. And mm-hmm. they give them their life back. And I think that's priceless.
There's no question. And not just adults, but kids look up to you, too. And we hear you have a five-year-old buddy named Sloan.
She's like my best
Dylan
friend.
Dylan and I had the chance to meet her this morning. Sloan is here with us this morning. Sloan, come here.
Come here, Sloan.
Come here, buddy.
We've got a whole group of
she
people.
She couldn't be more precious. Tell us about Sloan.
I recently met Sloan at the prosthetic office that we both go to. And I saw her, and she just inspired me so much. Mm-hmm. Just the fact that she is five and has no idea. She doesn't think she's any different because mm-hmm. she's not. And I think that we all need to remember that. Mm-hmm. She just lives her life, and I just really admire that.
How old are you, Sloan?
Five.
You're five. You're going to kindergarten next year, I hear.
Mm-hmm.
Do you love looking up to her?
Yeah.
Her legs are pretty cool, huh?
We saw Frozen the other night.
Oh,
fun. Yeah, it was really fun.
How cool is Lauren?
really cool.
She's really cool. That about sums that up, my friend.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much for being here, and I will see you all later tonight. We've got folks from the Challenged Athletes Foundation who are here as well. So I will see all of you tonight. It's so nice to have you here.
I love it.
Thank you so much. We'll be right back.